for any person who has a taxable income,
okay,
we'll be using whatever means are required. Okay?
Okay.
If you've managed to hide all your income through your M-Pesa transactions,
yeah,
you'll find us there. It's just a matter of what may be the challenge,
yeah,
is what I talked about, big data. You know, if you are getting all this big data at one go, you'd be able to run it through your data matching and isolate all these fellows,
yeah,
immediately. So each and every one of the people who would be on the not have declared income, we'd then be able to use that.
Okay.
But if we have reason to believe, because we all have to file our tax returns,
okay,
we have reason to believe that those returns are not consistent, we still have the means through all the laws that are in place,
okay,
to deal with that problem.
The existing law, as far as income tax is concerned, or even VAT is concerned, it puts an obligation on anybody doing business for income tax purposes, income that it derives from Kenya,
yeah,
should be subject to tax.
Okay.
For VAT, is it somebody supplying goods or services here in Kenya, it should be subject to tax. That is the basic principle.
Okay.
Now the question is whether KRA is actually monitoring these people. Yes, we are. And one of the challenges that probably is there is the problem of visibility of these transactions.
Okay.
How visible are they?
Mm-hmm.
Then that probably is the one that creates a challenge that needs us to put in more policy measures to enable us see this transaction through other means.
Mm-hmm.
And one of them is again automation of our systems. The other one is to provide some stopgap measure. And that some of these are already there. For example, the Tax Procedures Act provides for what we call tax incentives.
Your taxes should grow in line with the economy.
Okay.
Where a sector is expanding, you should actually see, if you have a good tax system, you should also be moving with that sector. We are not disengaged from the economy because, okay, you know, we see the data. We have, yeah, every single firm. We can see what the inputs are. We can see how much they're paying in salaries. We can see what they're making in sales. We can see what their profits are, and the taxes follow those kind of things.
Mm-hmm.
Second is the government has also done a lot to cushion the,
okay,
people who are hurting at the lower end. For example, we've had 2 years, I believe it's 2016-17, 2017-18, where the tax bands were widened,
okay,
to remove people who are at the bottom from having to pay the pay as you want. And of course, we've also seen the same thing happening since around 2013-14, where you're seeing certain sectors being cushioned,
mm-hmm,
from certain taxes. You remember right now, they've just brought in the rebates,
mm-hmm,
on electricity and so on and so forth. Now, the good thing with, for example, our approach towards using data matching and digital economy to help us identify taxpayers,
mm-hmm, yeah,
is that there are people who should be in the tax net who are not.
Yeah.
To the extent that somebody should be in the tax net and he is not,
yeah,
those who are in end up paying a higher tax burden.
Okay.
I mean, the tax burden is concentrated on fewer people.
Mm-hmm.
So you can find, for example, a school teacher, a primary school teacher,
yeah,
because their pay as you want is being deducted at source from the TSC,
yeah,
they're already paying taxes,
yeah,
right in the tax net. Mm-hmm. You might have somebody running some trucks in Kenya who's making a lot more than that teacher,
yeah,
but is out of the net. Our approach is to get that person into the net, and if you can get that person into the net, you then generate for the treasury the flexibility to say we can actually lower the burden for those who are paying because we've brought in people who are outside into the net. So we're not disengaged. In fact, the number of people we are finding who are not compliant and who are now being brought into the net tells us we are becoming more and more engaged.
Mm-hmm.